Good giggler morning, Sandrock. It's been a while. It's been like a month.
Month and a half. No.
No, it's just it said 23 last time.
Yeah, so about a month.
Well, just over half a month.
A long time.
Way too long time.
Oh, you're really starting off with something.
Imagine this is just instantly the end of the story.
That would be real funny. Just final episode, 1 minute long. Or you're like one of those fake video uploaders who are like, it's a 1 hour long thing, but it's just 1 minute. And then the rest is just, thank you for watching the series for like 59 minutes long.
Oh, no. I would absolutely continue on the hour then to just do some walking around in the improved Sandrock. And like getting memories and such back. And probably get some of the things from the past 100 videos back on screen.
I was just joking.
I know. But at the very same time, people do that for 59 minutes.
I know, that's what that's...
And it makes me facepalm.
I know, that's a joke.
Hey. I don't normally do video introductions or... Oh, video endings because of that it wonderful. Takes too long and I never imagined our there's no reason to so beautiful again. Thank you all for the help. Everyone worked hard on this.
Certainly, you all know that as well as anyone. Well, I thank you for your modesty. I hope after this you'll have a bit of time to rest, to stop and smell the roses, so to speak.
Rest is for the weak.
Our work is done, and it's time to disband Operation Flowergate once and for all.
No way. Plan till I die, Minister Birgie Boy. Plan till I die.
Oh, I mean, sure. We'll come up with some new organization when the need comes, but I think we've flowered this town up as far as it'll go.
Birches, you need some flowers.
Still hate how it's called Flowergate. I forgot those sculptures.
You might be right.
Burgess, open up your eye. I've got some flowers for you.
You know, the new landscaping does call for constant upkeeping.
Actually, there are edible flowers.
Yeah, so?
Burgess, open your mouth. I've got something great for you.
Okay.
I found it on the farm.
Oh.
Have fun eating manure.
So glad this game isn't in VR. Never thought I'd say that.
Prepared. Emergency meeting at the flower cave. Stat. Birgie boy.
Okay.
Those two? Glad they're on our side. Yeah, me too. You know, I'm just real glad the whole plan went off without a hitch. Not so surprising, considering all the wonderful people that worked on this. Coming from Highwind, I'm really surprised at the concentration of talented people in this town. And look at you! You've really shaped up into quite the Sandrock legend. Although, maybe I should have seen it coming. Even when we were kids, you'd be so reliable. Remember when we used to snag honey out of beehives? If you didn't always stand watch for the bee swarm, our faces might look a bit different right now.
Oh, really? Well, everyone gets their start somewhere.
You left out the part where I got stung to shit.
I was trying to give you credit. But sure, I lost count of how many times we had to scrounge together pocket change to get you that lotion with the picture of the bee on it. Oh, be careful, pain relieving ointment. That was it.
Sounds like you two got into all sorts of trouble growing up.
Hey, is it me, or is Big Tree on Mount Roxand looking a bit different?
Mama Tree!
Let's head over and check it out.
Well, Model, we've done it. Oh, if you could see our boy now.
Hey, Pa. Looks like others also noticed.
Hello, everyone.
This tree. It's time to grab the chainsaw.
Really?
Woohoo! Yeah, there are still some dead bits to the side. Literally, Mian is covering for a dead bit right now, from what it looks like. So now it's Trudy.
You saved the tree!
Looks just like it did 30 years ago.
Yeah, it's a miracle.
A scientific miracle! A miracle performed by us! And natural healing processes, etc.
I'm not even sure anymore.
I know. You worked very hard to make this happen. You didn't have to, but I am eternally grateful.
And now Mort is dead.
Being here with you guys for so long, this became our struggle too.
No, his tree is now grown. He can now die happily.
Wow, I'd forgotten what this view could look like.
My ma used to take me up here from time to time. After her disappearance, this tree died, and I never wanted to come up here again. But I guess everything turned out for the best.
Martel would have been very proud of what you accomplished, Zeke. Nearly 70 years of history has all led to this.
This is only the beginning. We made Sandrock green again. We can do anything!
Hey, Pa. Come look at this. Pa? Pa! Pa, are you all right?
Oh, I'm sorry. The journey up here seems to have really taken it out of me.
Glad you're all right.
Why wouldn't I be? I'm still fit as a fiddle.
Brr, do you all feel that? Suddenly got a bit nippy up here.
A wind blows. A gentle wind that once would have prophesied ruin now soothes me.
Ah, let's see. I am now allowed to go to Hogwarts.
Really?
Got caught in the leaves. I don't know. Could have gone straight through. It's Ma's letter from your scrapbook. The one that got blown off in the sandstorm. For it to end up all the way up here. Pa, we can put it back when we get home. Open it up when Ma comes back. Like you said.
No, it's time. I've known for some time now.
What's it say?
She wanted me to take you, Zeke, and ride down to Highwind.
What?
If you're reading this letter, I bet my life on Sandrock and lost. I failed Akil. I failed Theo. I failed Sandrock. And worst of all, I failed you, Mort. We've lost too many good people. And now there are none left. But our story doesn't have to end like this. Take Zeke east. Find a new life. Survive. I haven't lost everything if I know that you've made it. I can rest easy knowing you're safe. So, please, don't throw your life away chasing this foolish woman's foolish dream. Let Sandrock go.
You never opened it?
Hmm.
Would you have gone? If you'd known.
I would have. I came here a traveler, like everyone back then. I only stayed because of her. She inspired many of us. Her dream became our dream. And I loved her more than life itself. I would have done anything. I did when she disappeared. I couldn't believe it. Why would I? She spent months in that desert every year. I believed she would return, so... No, I did not read the letter. You carried the torch for her, Trudy, without question, and nearly met the same fate.
Oh.
Hey, Ma's spirit was stronger than her body could ever be. She gave us hope when there was none. Her memory kept us all alive, kept us fighting. There was only one thing she loved more than Sandrock. It was you and me, Pa.
You all were right. It is quite a view.
The wind's picking up. Come on, Mort. Let's get you down the mountain before you catch a cold.
If it's all right, I'd like to stay a little longer.
I've got him. You all go on ahead.
All right. Maybe better give him some space.
Don't stay up here too long, all right?
Look at us. A couple of old fools.
Pretty good. For a couple of fools.
Her dream. It came true after all.
All because of one stubborn old man.
Hey, you think that was Martel's spirit who sent Mort the letter just now?
Yeah, sure.
It's nice knowing that someone like Martel's up there watching over us. Things are not always as they seem. That's a lesson we learn time and time again in Sandrock. In my book, both Mort and Martel are both heroes, more than ever. Everyone will want to know the truth. But for now, let's just give them some peace. Good. Now, let's all get back to our greener Sandrock.
Well, Nia. Trudy, don't shoot a gun at me.
Wait, Trudy has a gun?
Yeah, she just grabbed a gun, aimed to our thing, and shot something behind me.
Yeah. There were enemies in my cutscene as well.
Like, look at that!
Damn. She knows how to use a gun, they would have thought.
But they actually know how to use a gun. There's a danger.
That's not what I meant. I wasn't expecting her to use a gun.
She's what, 100 years old? She's using a gun? It's dangerous.
That is... sure. We'll go with that. There's two main quests on the map for me.
I've got a lot more.
I think most of those are still statues, remember?
Yeah.
Or the hedge things.
Yeah, which is kind of annoying that they show up when you open up the map, but not on the mini map.
I think they should have had a different icon, personally.
Yeah,
just like a bush icon.
No, just make them the blue quest thing.
That would work too. Yeah, because they did the same thing for Yakima Station, don't they?
Yep.
Should have done that. Oh well.
I'm going home.
Fair enough.
Who knows? I might have one in my chest now.
Yep, let me know whenever you're ready to advance the story again.
Mass reply. I don't care about that. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, but you're fine. You have the inventory slots for it, I would hope.
Well, yeah, no, that's not... No, I've got all of them, literally.
I can buy 120 more. Still want to be level 60 so I can finally use my new sword. I might replace the Altair with Hades. This is just 10 times cooler. I love the Altair, but Hades.
There we go. That is all my missions, at least in the making now.
Fair enough.
But no, my response at the at that chest, out of the items, was literally because instantly the chest is like, oh yes, we have some water now as well. I'm like, second earlier, please. But no. Alright. Oh, Vivi. Robert, the fuck is in here? Heidi, whatever. Here's your commission. Hmm. I remember. Vertil gives you bang for your buck.
Yeah, sure.
Now, I don't know where which quest objective is, considering...
The one is at the church, and one is right below the... to the bottom right of the Civil Corps.
Okay. Church it is.
It's right on top of the Yakmel Station. Install? Oh, there's another. Never mind. That's also a. Why there? Why right behind? I don't have any of those, I think. All right, write down one more sculpture. I'm sorry. I thought that was.
Yeah, no. The only one is at the Silver Corps, I think, unless that is a big one.
This might be a big one.
I mean,
nope. So I need one more meerkat and one fennec. Never mind, they're all sculptures. I thought I did all of those last time. Maybe I missed one, I guess, or two.
It happens.
So I'll make one meerkat.
But that means that there is no story anymore for today.
And one fennec. I still need rose willow. I don't know actually if there will be. So, rose willow seeds will be done in about a day-ish. And I don't have to worry about them anymore. Let's go.
B. That's my button for
that. Nemo, dispatch. What should I do? Explore, collect water, dig, explore.
Ah, yes. Conserve water, Nemo.
I don't need him to get water for me. I have so much water.
Nemo, conserve water.
Nemo, drink as much water as you want. I really couldn't care less.
Wow.
I also have 3,000 too.
That was which one do we need again? Rose willows, right?
Yep.
Alright, well, considering I don't have any more of those in my inventory.
There we go. And I now have 412 water. I forgot how clean my... Every time I come back, I'm like, this place is so clean. Like, yeah, because all my dew collectors are all the way in the back. Which, it actually slightly gives me... It gives me a couple frame drops every now and then. Oh, well.
Let me see anyone in my inventory. God.
Okay. I've got nothing better to do.
Chestnut seeds, which I can't plant because I think they're tree by trees. These rhino horns, I also can't plant. Are you kidding me?
No.
For fuck's sake. There. Wait, what?
What?
Don't get too close to the wall when you're holding seeds.
What's the issue?
Well, the grid just gets to the wall. Or gets on the wall.
It's kind of funny, but... Just walk away.
No, I want to see what... Season?
Really?
Yeah! I like this.
What do you mean you like this?
Yeah, don't you see those poles sticking out of the wall?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
Why?
I think that's also just a side one. Jesus Christ. Even if you tried to put them on the wall, they will still point upwards.
Yeah, because the models weren't meant to be rotated, which means that they didn't implement a rotation feature for the models of the plants.
I'm just saying...
You're dumb, yes.
No, I'm saying that I like how it looks.
Yeah, I like it too, a model stick half through the wall. Well, then you're gonna love this game, because there's that happening everywhere. Most stuff like grass, but... I've got nothing good to do today.
Yeah, I've got my commissions right now with me. I just need to deliver them and that's it. Why the fuck do I have 48 wheat seeds now? Literally in my hand slot. Fuck off. There.
I don't know, I always have my entire slots full so that shit doesn't happen.
Yeah, I don't have it always full.
Well then have it always full.
No, because I literally don't have anything to put in there.
Well, there's plenty of stuff you could put in there.
Plenty of stuff that won't matter to me. Yeah, sure. Like, I'm not going to grab two guns just to carry them with me, because that would just be a waste of space. Are you kidding me? I went into this place just so I could give you your pipes, and you leave. But
oh, yes,
don't go. What? Fucking. Damn it! No, stop running.
Never.
By order of the riddle, stop running.
Hello, thank pumpkin. You. Change diaper. No diapers. Better head to the store. What store? I guess by the stairs.
It's always by the stairs.
Didn't know I had to actually financially like invest money into this kid.
I can tell you from my experience with Porsche, yes, you do have to.
It's fine, I've got 135k.
You also need to feed him.
No, Mian usually does that.
In Porsche, you just need to feed them. Diapers were not a thing.
Baby bottles, diapers, ginger syrup, and hot water bottle. I'll just buy max amounts of all of them.
Ah, yes, buy up his entire inventory.
I have like over 130 slots free. I'll be fine.
Nah, that sounds like a you problem. Right, that's the end of my day.
Well, I need to change the diapers on the baby and then I'll be free to go to bed.
Yeah, already. I will already go to bed. Hello, bed.
Yeah, screw the baby.
Wow.
Me, I will take care of him.
Fireside added to reminders. Are you kidding me?
Oh, I fed the baby. See, I'm not a horrible parent.
Yet.
That's not how this works.
Gold, limestone bricks, sure, limestone sticks, in case you have wooden planks, and then Tea leaves? Let's not have enough of those. 10 mountain rose. Sure.
Oh, I got a letter from Trudy.
Grace wants to play with me.
Pablo, come to my studio. Civil Corps. Letter from Ryan. Thanks for the simple chair, buddy. Elsie gave me 3 jerky. Okay.
I just got facial cream from Pablo. What the fuck?
I got a side quest right in front of my door.
Yeah, same. From.
It's sad to hear Mian still call me the builder. But it's fine.
Well, you'll always just be a builder to her.
It's like, that random builder I live with. But you know what? It's fine. It's like... Then just like have it that way in the text as well. Like, don't have my name, just say the building. It's fine.
There we go. Ah.
Great, isn't it?
Fuck the farm.
Why?
Not my problem right now. Hello, you two.
Look, there's the builder. Come join us. Mia needs your help.
What kind of help?
Well, you know how I've been helping out at the moisture farm. But with the greenification of Sandrock almost complete, I'm going to have more free time. So, I was thinking, maybe it's time for me to start something of my own. I want to settle down in Sandrock, just like you have. But I'm still not sure what that something should be. Mian told me to follow my dreams and do what my heart desires.
Well, Nia, you can sleep in my house, I guess.
You know, I've always had a passion for tending to various plants in the garden since I was a kid.
Didn't you, like, deny... Your,
shut your cake hole.
Like how many times?
Oh, fuck you. You should bring some rare varieties of plants for sale.
That's an interesting idea, but it might take time. Ooh, I could open a shop. But what would I sell?
Damn.
Gardening tools? That's perfect. And you could also sell flowers.
No flowers. Nia, you do crops.
How dare you tell her what to do with her life? No wonder she denied you.
Look, nobody wants gardening tools.
Are you sure about that?
I don't want them. I want crops.
Ah, yes, I forgot.
And I'm going to be her main customer. Because nobody buys from by the stairs, apart from us.
Don't you remember the time that Arvia sold a picture of his sister? People bought that.
I used to dream of opening a bakery or a...
Well, yeah, because people are simps for her.
I became a builder like the rest of my family.
Fair. Never mind.
Like you can't make that argument with me.
Hey, you're taking us by the stairs. So.
No, it was just him.
Technically, I think it would probably... Legally speaking, it would probably count as being sold by the stairs. I
love having the yes, and everyone had to be returned.
Sure more people like me in Sandrock,
yes.
And we don't have a store catering.
So none of those sales count in the end.
But still.
No. None of those sales have ever counted.
They technically count. They just really count as refunds as well.
Yeah, so... Effectively, nobody wants anything from by the stairs.
I see. Selling flowers
disagree.
Makes sense. It's easier than
I agree with myself.
Tools, which I have to
import. Where do you think they get the fireworks from?
But with flowers, I can grow them.
They
myself.
Can make them themselves.
Perhaps Zeke would even let me use a plot in his moisture.
Sure.
Farm.
Besides, I literally don't ever see fireworks.
I know I could ask my family for support as a last resort.
I have been fireworks in the
I'd
past.
I'd prefer to figure it out on my own.
What should I say? I can lend you the money.
Really? really, really?
Five, oh god.
Yeah, I saw that as well. Doesn't even tell you, like, hey, here's how much it'll cost. Roll in.
Five, but 20 relationship points, which I guess, yeah, sure.
Now, let's think about the location. The main street doesn't have much space for a new shop. And if we set up too far from the town center, it might be inconvenient for people, especially if they want to buy those heavy gardening tools.
I have a balcony in front of my workshop that's currently free to use, but it's not big enough for a whole shop.
What if we just set up a flower display rack there?
Ah, a display rack with a canopy! That sounds about right. It'll look lovely on my balcony and provide some extra shopping space. By the way, I still have some extra funds left after donating to the Sandrock School, so I thought you could have it. You know, it's like an investment.
Mian, don't also give her money. She's mine.
Thank you, but what the builder has offered is more than enough.
See?
Let's hope I get my money back.
But it's just I'd really love to be a part of
this. Of course not.
I don't care about money.
I told you I dreamed of opening a shop when I was a kid, and I wasn't joking. I just never got the chance. That's why I want to invest in the business. I thought you could use some extra goals to order different flowers from other places and attract more customers. And I could help you with whatever you need help with. I kind of wish to run the business with you. Is that a possibility?
Mian, you're going to ruin my chances by gluing up to her.
Ah, I see. Of course. I'd love to be business partners with you, Mian. It would be a dream come true for both of us.
Great.
Really? Thank you so much, Nia. Just tell me what you need me to do. While I may not be an expert in planting, I'll try my best. I'll even ask Zeke to teach me some techniques.
That's all right. We'll figure out the planting part together. First, let's come up with a name for our business. Even if it's just a few racks, it's our special place. Any ideas?
Naming isn't my thing. Mostly because I don't care. I know that Mian is in it.
Why? What's wrong with Mian? What do you have against Mian?
My workshop wouldn't just be called Mian's workshop.
How dare you?
I'm good at it.
Well, I dare very easily.
The worst.
It was a bold statement. I'm keeping with that.
Just the worst.
What should we call the flower shop? Just call it flower shop. For the love of God, don't ask me.
It's a little non-specific. Every other shop in town has a name.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
We should have something special too.
Name it after you and me, Anne.
I thought so too. I want the name to represent both of us in some way.
But Mian, Mian, Mian. They don't sound very catchy.
How about we put your name first? We could call it me Minnie. Because it's small and cute. Plus, people will immediately know it belongs to you and me.
That's brilliant! I love it! How about Minnie Botanica? It reflects that we sell not only flowers, but also plants and everything related to gardening.
It's settled then. Let's name it Minnie Botanica. We have a name and a location. Now I need to prepare some flowers for sale. And of course, the flower display rack. Anything you can help with?
I can help build the display rack.
Oh, that would be so special. You two grew up together, and now you're literally helping Nia build her business.
I'm not going to grow flowers for you because I literally can't right now.
I'll help with growing the flowers. I'm not an expert, but I'll do whatever Nia asks me to do.
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it in no time. Okay, I'll design a recipe for the display rack.
And I'll ask around and see what people want to buy from our shop and then get the flower seeds.
Sounds like a plan. Thanks for your help. We'll send you what you need tomorrow.
Goodbye. See you soon.
Ah, yes. Okay. Commissions.
So, did you also get a letter from Pablo?
Yep.
Something tells me they just want to give you a taste of what the DLC will look like. Because the fashion show will have both the swimwear and I think the other ones, the Starry Night or something, the Starlight. stuff. So something tells me they just want to show you in game what it looked like, which I actually kind of appreciate.
Yeah, but hosted by Pablo.
Yeah, I don't know. Thanks. Pablo's been such a nothing character. Again, no offense.
All the offense.
Nope, no offense. But he's a nothing character.
He is a nothing character. He will never be an anything character.
He could be. What if, like,
nope. Nope.
They make like a DLC, Pablo's Revenge, for all the players who shit on him for being worthless.
Yeah, he is worthless, and he got it all. He got himself to thank for that.
Yeah. I mean, it's a bit rude.
Also, if you look on the map right now, those main quests have disappeared.
Oh yeah, you're right. Do you think we can't place them anymore?
Well,
that would be real sad.
Or they're just placed already.
No, I don't think they would do that.
I'm going up right now to one of the spots, so...
I'm going to literally the other one. Yeah, they... Huh. They are placed randomly. That... Did you craft any?
Luckily not. Luckily, mine were... I've put them in the production queue, but I guess I'm running back now to take them out. To take them out, literally.
Interesting, yeah.
It's far better.
I mean, I'm not disagreeing, but like... Oh, I'm missing something. Blueprints. I have enough bed for wood. I think I don't have enough sisal. Yeah, I need to get more sisal.
Alright, factory.
Where the hell do I get sisal from again?
I don't know.
Of course you don't know.
Cancel.
What do you know?
Cancel. 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 And cancel! Fuck you, Hedges!
Sisal is a bush? Like, I have some sisal.
When will people learn?
Alright, two commissions for Owen.
Thank you. Thank you.
I already forgot what sisal looked like.
A plant.
Good God, you're so helpful.
Yes. Now I can actually do my gardening without any troubles.
I don't do my gardening at all. I have one hyacinth orchid. Bitter beans.
My rose willows were done growing as well.
Right.
Yeah, I'm glad that's now done.
Sisal. From log. Right. My bad. How could I possibly forget? It was from log.
Riddle.log.
Sources are the sisal tree, which are in the Valley of Whispers, mostly. So I guess I'll head there.
Yeah, that's the only choice you have at this point.
Yeah, well, assume that they are still there, because, you know, Katori world.
Yeah, no, she is known for... Suddenly getting rid of everything.
It is kind of funny though. Did you start off the game preserve water and trees and cacti and stuff, and here we are, chainsaw in hand.
Yep.
This is not a sisal tree though. It is a sisal tree. They're cactus looking things. The cactus pineapple. There you go.
Yeah. He just destroyed SpongeBob's house.
I said pineapple-looking things. I didn't say it was a literal pineapple.
Nope. That SpongeBob is now homeless.
Good for him.
Homeless SquarePants.
Uh-huh.
There's one here. Nia's at the tree. Okay.
All of them spend time with Nia, does everything for it, but fuck, man, I have to click two buttons in order to travel to that location? Nah.
No, I just don't like going to that tree.
Why?
I just don't like the location.
It's on top of a mountain with a nice view.
I don't care about the view, I'd much rather have it somewhere in the town. Yes, Pablo, I promised you I'd help.
I knew you'd remember. I've already finished designs for two collections. I'll give you a sneak preview.
I designed See, that two looks sets almost clothing, exactly like some DLC formal
wear and swimwear. I've made more than 10 sets for each design.
They are, well, swimwear classy.
I always thought Sandrock of all places wouldn't need swimsuits of all things. But here we are, with the lush trees, the flowing water, and the longing for a long dip.
Dot, dot, dot.
So, light bulb moment.
What?
Swimsuits.
Just anything Pablo is saying.
What?
I never thought this day would come.
It's just...
But I finally think the time is right. I am going to put these on the catwalk.
Be a little nice to him.
A fashion show? I'm excited. No, how can I help?
I want to host a fashion show. As I was drawing them, I could picture it. The lights, the gasping faces, the stunning designs, and me at the back needling the final touches on a hypnotizing piece.
None of your pieces can be hypnotizing. If your clothing does that, then Jesus fucking Christ, you're in the wrong business.
What business should it be in?
Hypnotist.
Focusing on one series. This was,
that's not, it's not very specific. In
fact, no, he should do hypnotizing. If he wants to hypnotize people or things, do hypnotizing, don't do clothing.
Yeah,
because clothing isn't supposed to be hypnotizing.
There's multiple like ways you can use that. You can use it for like therapy or as a magician's trick. You know, you could be a bit more specific. What the fuck?
I don't care which one he does. If he wants to do anything hypnotizing, then...
Fair.
It's his own choice to save what he does within that field, but if he wants to hypnotize people, then don't do clothing.
So glad you took it literally.
Yeah.
Because this joke is really just getting better by the second.
It's not a joke.
Uh-huh.
Also, why did you jump over those things?
Because why not?
Those gates are there for a reason, and he just jumps over them.
Yes.
Now, what else is needed?
Cause I have to pay.
Pablo, I don't know what else is needed, but I assume you'll enlighten me.
First of all, clothing production. I am but the designer. I do not possess the skill to create these magnificent pieces.
Okay.
Ha! I can see your expression. No, I do not need you to make them. I have already asked Vivi, and she has agreed to work with me.
Thank the Lords.
Now, the issue of the venue. Trudy believes that the show could bring in tourists and offered to host it outside the city hall. But the construction of the stage will be your piece de resistance. With Trudy's support, honestly, this has grown bigger than I could have imagined. I even have my models, and they love the designs. Heidi's already made a diagram for you. You just need to make it and give it to me. That's not a problem, right?
Sure, you can count on me.
You're quite the go-getter, aren't you?
Don't sound too excited. Positively charming.
Well, I just have to prepare the clothes, organize the order of the show, then, when you have built the stage, please give it to me. Believe me, Sandrock will soon be the cosmopolitan hub of the free cities.
Okay, you're never going to design my clothes though, Pablo. I need petrified wooden sticks and poplar wood boards.
Yep.
I'm going to make them. Yeah, I'm going to construct a runway. I'm going to see if it actually does that.
For me, I am currently 17 hours away, so I will not have it done before 2 a.m., so it's probably better to just wait until the next day for me.
Yeah, but I want to see if it actually makes it to begin with.
Yep.
Because if it doesn't...
17 hours.
Begin production. Okay, 1654. I want to see if it's actually ticking down.
It is.
Yeah, now I can see that it's actually ticking down.
You can see when the gears are moving, that's when it's actually like making it.
Yeah, I'm much rather look at the time rather than moving gears.
You can also just look at the fact that there's no that there's no like little danger sign thing. Exclamation mark. There you go.
Still.
Hello, Mian.
Oh, didn't expect to run into you here. Came to enjoy the view?
Well, yeah, you're the most beautiful sight in the world, so yeah, I came to enjoy the view.
Really? Let me enjoy this view as well. 3, 2, 1, staring contest!
Oh god.
She already blinked.
You blinked.
No, I just...
The blush effect is something.
It's very...
It's very pink.
Oh, Sandrock, it's just so... sandy!
Sandy? Where?
Anyway, I'm here to collect some samples. Look at this. Now that the mama tree is back to life, other plants are thriving around it. Life truly begets life. I know we're joking around just now, but you're right. It really is a beautiful sight. When trees reach a certain age, they start being a life support system for various other life forms in the ecosystem. Each has its own preferences and requirements, but even with that, they grow together like a family made of different parts. I need to collect some specimens so I can really get into the nitty-gritty of how they're growing. But I kinda forgot to bring my climbing gear. Can you give me a boost? I just need to ascend a bit and collect some plant samples from up there. Just like how we used to collect cherries.
Just be careful.
You're the best. Back in Highwind, I took a field research course, and loads of it was climbing into these crazy places to collect samples. Collecting samples isn't as easy as just taking a handful and moving on. You need to be careful you maintain their structure and integrity. Nature is delicate, you know? Don't worry. I've done this loads before. Look, I'll climb up from right there. I see it. Oh, just a little further. That's it. Oh, just a little more.
Welp!
Just now, you... Did you mean it? I have something I want to say. Since we've been young, I've always had you with me. I don't know when, but I started to feel comfortable, familiar, when you're here with me. When you left Highwind, it felt like a part of me left. I felt... just pure loss. I didn't know how to cope until I saw you again. I know that visit was only 3 days, but I couldn't get it out of my mind. Every day after that, it felt like I couldn't wait to get to Sandrock to see you again.
I'm glad I went to the tree.
Okay.
I still hate how it had to be this tree. But I'm glad I went nonetheless.
Take what you can get.
Yeah, because I don't even think I need to do anything special now with the... With giving her that thing.
I don't know.
Considering our character have literally just kissed. In a cutscene.
How's that possible? You have a helmet on, that's not how it works.
That is how it works.
Nope.
Go Cosmetics mean nothing.
Okay.
In a cutscene, it's just a cosmetic.
As time went on, I focused on my studies, but that feeling never left. I kept walking past the train station, imagining myself leaping onto the next train. When Professor Luo and I got the invitation to come to Sandrock, I felt like I was walking into a daydream. That feeling has now been replaced by the shiver of excitement. In all this time, I've realized I love you.
What? There we go. Never even needed to give her that thing.
That's probably why she kept rejecting you.
Could be.
I think I always have. I tried to fight it, say that we're just good friends, but it's just not true. But now, you... It seems like you feel the same way?
You? Not in a million years.
I want to see you say that, to be entirely honest. That'd be really funny.
After this hour, I will do a save and then just load back the last save and just see what it does.
That's so mean.
What? I just want to know.
Mm-hmm.
Of course I do.
Really? You feel the same?
Nia became your sweetheart. Nia became your lover.
That was quick.
I skipped an entire stage.
Well, you had the advantage.
The advantage?
That you already knew her, technically, kind of. In lore, you already knew her for a long time, so. That's the advantage.
No, I think the advantage is the fact that this is a cutscene romance rather than a, hey, just give this to the person, and that's that.
That too.
Which, it does show that they've actually added those, rather than, you know.
In 11 days, you can get, you can buy a ring from the mysterious trader.
Oh, I already have that.
Never mind.
Then...
Watch her just deflect it again.
I love you.
Really funny.
Today is my lucky day, I guess. I picked some samples, and got a little surprise, too. Anyway... I'm going to go to the moisture farm to process these samples. Bye-bye, sweetie. That feels a little weird still. I'll see you later, okay?
Alright, job done.
You called that a job?
Yep. My life is now complete.
Mm-hmm.
Look here.
Ah...
I've had these as well next to it.
Mm-hmm. You don't even need the sweetheart cake.
Maybe you do. For a new nickname in the end.
Yeah, but
I don't know what nickname she will give me from the get-go.
I was able to select one.
Yeah, just safety.
Fair enough.
You never know what the game does considering my relationship went different than yours.
Fair enough.
Nia!
I can't wait for a mini botanica to open. It may not be much, but it's something I can call my own. It'd make my ma and pa proud. Today, everything changed. This is the first day of my new life. I never want to be apart from you again.
Interact. Yes! In the relationship to compose them during the night. Oh, Jesus. Okay. I will do a quick save.
It'd be so funny if she just turns you down, dude. Be so funny.
Do you remember that little fashion ship?
There we go. And then you.
I really hope she's gonna turn it down.
I just wanna know what happens. Yeah, I can't even give these anymore. So these two, I can. Oh, wow.
Damn. I told you.
Why is the... Just now, load.
Immediately turned you down.
Why the fuck is... What? Is quick load not bound, or is there simply no quick load button?
I have no idea. I don't quick load.
Well, I literally just made a quick save. Well, I was hoping to quick load it with F9.
No, maybe you just didn't set it.
Or maybe there's just no button for it to begin with.
Also, the getting off the runway gives you your gold back as you lent to or gave / donated to Nia.
Wait, there's audio? There's Builder's voice?
There's a voice setting for the Builder?
Audio.
Since when? I have mail too.
I've been on no voice the entire time.
I didn't know about it. It doesn't even allow me to test it. It just has voice options. Okay. Great. I did not know that was an option, to be honest. But apparently I have a male voice too the entire time. All are muted in the background. Wow, there's been new options. I guess that's the issue with if you don't...
If you don't look at them like every day that you play.
Every update. I was going to say, don't read through the patch notes. There you go.
Already learned Fashion Runway. Then why do I sell the book?
Wait, what? Did you get an extra one?
I don't know why, but...
Huh.
I never even needed that because it was instantly in my list of things to make rather than as book.
Yep. I don't even have the book. I just immediately had the recipe for it.
Yeah, for some reason I got both the recipe and the book.
That is
kind of funny. That about?
It's funny.
No, it's not.
I think it's hilarious.
I hate that extra item.
What commission should you take next? It's almost 8. Maybe you should just... I don't know. Well, see ya.
I'm going to go see RVO.
For?
I need a new bed.
Ah, right. A doll bed might be convenient. I have a starry night.
Adult bed? You mean a bed for two people?
Did I say adult bed?
Yes.
I said double bed.
No, you said adult.
I swear I meant to say adult bed.
I know.
God, I'm just saying because you fucking said it. I said double bed in my head. Maybe I'm just going crazy.
Let me buy this and this.
A baby's crib.
You never know how quick things go.
Stop. This is creepy now.
No, I genuinely mean it. Like, no. You never know. Like, nope. It could, like... I don't know how long it took for you before you had your baby.
A long time, because by the time I married her, the update for babies weren't even out yet.
Yeah, so it could be that to me it only takes like 1 or 2 weeks. I don't know how the game processes that.
I don't know. It's just funny, the first thing you do, imagine saying to somebody, hey, you know what, I think you should move in with me, and then the first thing you have is like, set us the baby's crib in the corner, just in case.
Yeah, you know, safety first.
Doesn't help.
You. There we go, fuck you.
God damn it.
Please.
I really want familiar faces. Ooh, maybe I can make that one actually. It's a sword and shield combo, but it looks awesome. Vintage shotgun. Ah, yes, I'll make a shittier shotgun than the one I have. Rune Ohm. That looks awesome as well. Dude, you can make a light hammer. We're at level 55.
Place!
Oh, here it is. Familiar faces. I'll craft one. I don't have poplar wood, though.
Place!
Do you remember where we get poplar wood?
Place!
Helical skier sword and shield? That looks awesome, but it's lower level, so I have no reason to use it. No offense.
Place! How much redecorating do I need to do to fit this bed in first?
I'll get poplar wood tomorrow, and then I'll make the familiar faces so I can use it instead of the katana. This altar.
I don't want it. Sure. Sure, you know what? Sure. There. Job done. This bed. Fuck off with that. Crip goes right here.
The late game weapons, dude, are fucking awesome. Because they're all made by other people, by people like donated, I would assume. During the Kickstarter. They look so cool. So much more unique. No offense to the original designers. I like a light hammer. It's just a
And before Boros comes in and is like, that doesn't feel like it should be in the game.
I'm not gonna comment on that.
Why the fuck is the other thing that I put in my inventory?
What are you talking about?
I put
Go back, I saw it. Yeah, that one. What other thing?
I put something else in my inventory to Dead Space.
Well, what did you put in there? Why don't you? There's literally sorting tabs, right? Like, damn. So like.
There. Beautiful.
Fuck. Don't. Nope. Stop. Put it down.
Never.
Nope.
Alright. My house. Now a space for both me and her.
And the crib?
Yeah, that one was awesome. I've already put that down.
I was just asking.
Look, it's here.
I wasn't paying attention. I was just looking at some of the weapons.
I mean, there's a chest.
A chair.
A chair and a techno box. Which...
A techno box is a little rusty. Probably isn't good for the child. But
No. Extra rust makes the child learn.
Learn what? How diseases work?
Yes.
Okay.
Now this is my side. And then we'll go to sleep.
Wait. You should first set Nia's side, I think.
Why?
It's empty. You should set her side as well. Where am I crazy? Oh, she doesn't
I'm not married yet.
Right. I forgot that takes a
Jesus,
while.
Fuck.
I thought that... Like,
also, I didn't give her the ring in the end. I quick loaded, remember?
I thought being a couple also allowed her to move in, but that's my...
No. Couples shouldn't just randomly move in.
I don't know, man.
But, that was an hour. And that was a very good hour.